And in this problem, a uniform rod of weight 200 Newton, this is a rod of weight 200 Newton, stand vertically. A light string connect the midpoint of the rod to the floor. This is the string which is connecting the midpoint to the floor. A block of weight 100 Newton, this mass M, this is weight 100 Newton, is connected to the top of a horizontal string passing through a frictionless pulley. What are the horizontal and vertical forces exerted by the floor on the rod? You have to find the horizontal and vertical forces exerted by the floor on the rod. So let the vertical forces exerted by the floor on the rod be N, and of course horizontal forces, the cylinder will have a tendency to pull in this way, that the direction. So let this will be the horizontal forces, which is nothing but friction at the floor, right? So this will be the case. Now you have to solve the problem. Here it is given, let tension in string, this will be the tension in string be T1. In this string it is T1, and so here also it is T1, and for this string it is T2. For this string it is T2. So the point of action is midpoint of E. Now weight of this rod is 200 Newton, and weight of this suspended mass is, weight of this suspended block is all 100 Newton, right? So obviously the whole system is in equilibrium, so we can have this T1 will be equal to M1G, right? Mg, this T1 will be equal to Mg, and which is nothing but 100 Newton. So we have this T1 is equal to 100 Newton. The tension T1 will be equal to 100 Newton, right? Now for equilibrium of the rod, we can have, what is the horizontal forces acting on the rod? So right side we will take positive, right? Sigma fx ki baat kar raha hai. So for equilibrium of the rod, sigma fx must be equal to 0. And what are right side forces? This is T1 plus F. This T1 plus friction F. Now here the string tension, this will have two components. This is 30 degree. So one component will be in this direction, right? This is 37 degree, this is also 37 degree, and second component will be in the direction. So this will be equal to T2 cos 37, and this will be T2 sin 37, right? Sin 37. For 37, we can find, now this is a very simple angle, this is 37, so this is 3, this is 4, and this is 5. So cos 37 degree 4 by 5, we have here cos 37 is equal to 4 by 5, and sin 37 will be equal to 3 by 5, right? So for horizontal forces, T1 plus F, right? What is component? This is T2 cos 37 minus T2 cos 37 minus T2 cos 37. This must be equal to 0. This must be equal to 0. Or we can say, what is the value of T1? This is 100 plus F minus cos 37. 4 by 5, which is equal to 0.8 T2, this is equal to 0, right? Or we can say that this F minus 0.8 T2, this will be equal to minus 100. This is equation number 1. Now for vertical forces, what are the vertical forces? We can add vertical forces, we make sigma Fy is equal to 0, taking the upward forces as positive. So we have this N minus weight of the rod, which is equal to 200 in Newton. So N minus 200 Newton, and this component of tension T2, which is T2 sine 30 degree. So minus T2 sine 30 degree, sine 37 degree. This must be equal to 0. So we have N is equal to 200 plus sine 37. Here we can see sine 37. This is 0.62. This is 0.62, right? And we have T2, right? So we have variable for it. This is equation number 2. This is equation number 2. Now, if we will take torque about this point, center of the rod. Now, taking torque about center of the rod, right? So, tau about point O, we can say, this is point O. Tau O is equal to how much? Now, it is T1 into L by 2. This is clockwise. So, we can say it as negative, and similarly, plus L by 2 into F, this is anti-clockwise. The K is point per A, anti-clockwise friction. So this will be positive. T1 clockwise is negative. And torque produced by T2 cos 37 is equal to 0. So this will be equal to 0 because it is the case of equilibrium. And so from here, we can have L by 2 cancel ho gaya. So this will give us T1 will be equal to AF, that is 100 Newton. T1 will be equal to AF, that will be 100 Newton. So from here, AF, from equation number 1, we have AF plus 100 will be equal to 0.8T2, right? And this will give T2 is equal to how much? We have T2 is equal to 200, and this will be 0.8. So this will give, okay, F, value of F is, now here it is F, so this will be 0.8 into T2, and this will be equal to how much? 100 is equal to F plus 100, ho jaye, to F ka value already 100 hai, so this will be equal to 200. Right, so this will be 200 divided by how much? 0.8. Right, 200 divided by 0.8. So we have T2 is equal to 200 divided by 8, that is 2000 divided by 8. And this will be equal to 2, and this will be equal to 500. So this will be 250, right? This will be 250. 500 by 2, which is equal to 250 Newton. So T2 is equal to 250 Newton, and then accordingly we can find N. Then accordingly we can find N. N will be equal to how much? N will be equal to 200 plus 62. From where we can have 200 plus 0.62. That is, this is 200 and 0.6. T2 is 250. Right? So this will be equal to 200 plus 150, so this will be equal to 350 Newton, right? This will be equal to 350 Newton, and this will be the answer. So total forces in vertical direction is this 350 Newton, and this horizontal force is 100 Newton.